Welcome back to another episode of Tailwaggers TV. In this episode, I'm going to talk about the raw food diet again and alternate ingredients that you can use from the last video I did. Some will be the same, some will be different, but also I want to talk a little bit more about supplements and also direct aids for things like yeast infections, poor skin, things like that, and also allergies. So basically, the recipe I'm going to use today is a grain-free and hopefully completely hypoallergenic diet. Some dogs may be allergic to things like turnips or carrots or potatoes, but most times, 9 times out of 10, they're allergic to either the certain type of protein that you use, whether it be beef or tripe, sometimes even lamb, or even, it's mostly grains though. Grains are the huge culprit, so things like brown rice, oats, millet, even though they are very nutritious, they should be either used at a minimum or not at all. So with this one, it's going to be a grain-free diet, so I'm just going to go through the ingredients very quickly and show you how to make it. So basically, all you do is take a turnip and chop it into huge chunks, like this. It doesn't have to be anything pretty, and they don't have to be very small because they're going to be going into a food processor anyway. Then you would take your carrots, and basically I just chop them into large chunks like this. I always take off the ends and set that aside, and then take a potato. This is a good sized potato for one meal. If you're going to be doing several meals and pre-making like 4 or 5 meals, then you'd want to use like 2 or 3 of these and just chop them thickly. You know, it doesn't have to be too precise. And this one I'm going to use pears. I usually use apples, but just to change it up a bit, pears are excellent. They're very good for the digestion, and they also provide a lot of nutrients. So make sure you always remove all seeds and pits or anything that's inside fruit. You never want to include those in because a lot of them have toxic chemicals in them. So again, just chop them thickly and into huge chunks and pop them into your food processor. Once you've gotten them all put in there, you want to get your meats. And for this time I used chicken. So you just get the prize choice free flow chicken. You can do lamb. I also have tripe or beef, and they're down at my shop in Kilcoggan. And if you haven't thawed them beforehand, a lot of people are in a hurry. They don't remember to take out the ingredients from the freezers and things like that. All you have to do is get something like this. It's a nice strainer, and then a bowl of some kind, and just pop the meat right inside the strainer, and then you drop it in there. Put tepid water in there. You don't want to do it too hot, just in case it does cook it a bit, and then let it soak for a few minutes and it should be fine. By the time you've chopped all your veg, your meat should be thawed. So pop all the veg and the meat inside the food processor, and then I add sunflower oil. I like organic, but I use about 2 tablespoons of sunflower oil for a full pot this size, and then I do about 4 pumps of the Scottish salmon oil. The salmon oil is excellent for healthy skin and coat. This is excellent for healthy skin and coat as well, but it's also really good for helping keep in shed. So once we've got all the ingredients in there, we just grind it up, and this is the finished product. I made it earlier, so you didn't have to hear it. And there it is. Now, what you can do with this is you can just scoop it out with a large spoon and pop it into their bowl, or you can take a measuring cup of some kind and then, you know, individually scoop it out. After a while, you're going to eyeball it. You're really not going to use measurements, and it's going to be just a free-for-all. You're just going to start throwing everything in there, grind it all up, and just be able to look at it and tell exactly how much you're going to feed. Other supplements I like to use, besides things like probiotics and spirulina, are things like calcium ascorbate crystals. It's a buffered vitamin C, and vitamin C is excellent for clearing the digestive tract of mucus. And mucus is a great home for viruses, bacteria, and even yeast fungal infections. This is more of a direct aid. It's quercetin and bromelain. Quercetin, if you've probably read in my blog earlier, it comes from apple skins and the skins of red onions. It's a natural antihistamine. Each tablet has 300 milligrams of bromelain in it. Now you can grind this with a mortar and pestle, or you can drop it right into the food, into the bowl, and typically, usually the dogs won't even know it's there. And what that'll do is get into the bloodstream, it'll clear the blood of any histamines, and the itching should stop. Allergens are a huge problem with dogs. most people don't realize that they have just as many allergens as we do. We'll go get a blood test to find out what we're allergic to, and they don't really have any way of finding that out. So what we do is process of elimination. Start with the most basic recipes and then add ingredients and watch for a day or two when you add a new ingredient to see if there's any allergic reaction or any reaction at all. Check the stool, make sure there's no diarrhea. Check the skin, make sure there's no dry patches or dermatitis, and watch them. Generally, they'll either slow down or even speed up. Some dogs might get more hyper. But typically itching is the first symptom of food allergy or allergy of any kind. So watch the skin. Also, changing the diet up every week, changing the protein that you use, the different meats, changing the veg, and maybe using a sweet potato versus a white potato. These are all ideas of changing the diet up so that they're not eating the same thing day in and day out, and they can develop a food allergy or resistance to certain ingredients if they're overused. So changing it up is always a good idea, but always do it for a full week at a time. So that way, if there's any sign of food allergy from any new ingredients that you use, you can pinpoint them and you can eliminate them altogether. Eggs are a huge problem with some dogs. They can have a couple, maybe one or two a week, but if they have it every day, they can end up with inflamed ears, itchy skin, and diarrhea. So keep your eye on your pets and make sure they're as healthy as can be. So for a full list of recipes, ingredients, and supplements you can give your pets, please visit my website at www.tailwaggers.ie. Thanks, and have a great day. Bye!
Acho que não vou deixar você sair da minha vida. Sei que você vai gostar de estar no meio dessa briga. O que passou foi bom demais pra nós dois. Nosso destino é desse